This is a hammer, but this is the tech news. It might be hard to believe that AMD has been around for 50 years. The golden anniversary if you've been married for that long or had to shop for an anniversary gift for your grandparents. So fittingly, AMD has released gold editions of both the Ryzen 7 2700X and Radeon 7. While it doesn't look like either product will actually be gold colored, they will come in gold packaging with a CPU featuring the CEO Lisa Su's signature. Both products will come with copies of the Division 2 and World War Z, as well as a commemorative t-shirt. You should pick up both a CPU and graphics card right now, if you have a gold system, I guess. But it's not even gold. Why did they even do this? Like, we made a freaking gold CPU. Come on, AMD. Now, despite Samsung's folding phone, well, folding due to high failure rates, other phone manufacturers think they can pull it off. A new foldable Motorola Razr might be in the works, and the newest revision looks to feature a screen that folds vertically, harkening back to the days when having a flip phone made you the cool kid in high school. Do you remember
that?
Those
things were awesome.
They were so sick. Keep in mind, these rendered images of the new Razr aren't official, but seeing Motorola filed a patent in 2018 for a similar device, this could be very close to the real deal. There's no word when it might come to market, but it's speculated to be cheaper than the Galaxy Fold, so if nothing else, at least when you break it, it'll be easier to replace.
You buy two instead of one.
Yeah, just skip the middle man, just, But maybe instead of a foldable phone, you want one that, blows?
Yeah.
Oh, like with the fan on the inside, okay. The Chinese company Nubia is coming out with just such a fan phone, dubbed the Red Magic 3. Although other phone manufacturers have had external fan attachments for gaming-orientated devices, the Red Magic 3 appears to be the first one that has a real internal fan built in. Its internal specs look pretty solid for a flagship tier device, including a 90Hz display, and seeing that the overheating has been a legitimate issue with other gaming phones, this might turn out to be a pretty
oof, cool!
Cool idea, yeah, you got it. It's set to launch in Europe, Canada, and the US in late May, just in time to put the phone's fan to the test outside in 30 degree heat. Nothing, Colton?
It's gonna be hot.
Come on, yeah.
That's good.
Yeah, it is good.
Woo!
Now to the quick bits. Sponsored by Honey, the shopping tool that finds the best promo codes wherever you shop online at specific sites. Those of you who downloaded Honey from our link have already saved over $100,000 in the past few months. For those of you that don't know what Honey is, it's a free browser extension that saves you time and money when shopping online at over 30,000 stores. Honey works on Amazon, eBay, Newegg, Razr, Best Buy, Walmart, and even more. Get Honey for free right now and join honey.com/techlinked.
Did you know it even works on our merch store?
It even works on our merch store.
Wow.
On to the quick bits. Driving can be expensive, but Jaguar Land Rover wants to pay you for driving their cars, and not just by sticking tacky ads all over the side. Instead, the automaker is starting a program that will pay drivers in crypto for sending info about traffic and road conditions to help aid in both navigation services and local transit authorities. Jaguar also wants drivers to be able to use said crypto to automatically pay for things like tolls and beverages. So, sharing this info might save you a minute the next time you go to Tim's or somewhere that actually has respectable coffee.
Oh, come on, Tim's is great.
It's garbage ever since Burger King got them. Next time you're using Chrome browser on your smartphone or tablet, be wary that you might notice something funny happening with the address bar. One developer recently noticed that it would be quite easy for an attacker to replace it with a fake address bar once you start scrolling. Hopefully Google fixes this kind of attack before, like, some hacker sees a video about this exploit and gets an idea to do that? Wait, we just did that.
Yeah.
Oh. Don't do that, hackers.
No.
What is now unsurprising news, considering how many high-profile data breaches there have been lately? There's been a high-profile data breach!
Yeah!
Yeah! Yeah, yeah. A pair of researchers have discovered a huge Microsoft database that it's just sitting unprotected and contains a bunch of information like names, addresses, income, and marital status of over half of the households in the US. Microsoft hasn't commented on this, but you should think twice before fudging your salary numbers on your next hot date, or just don't lie to your dates, because that's bad.
I guess so.
Yeah, don't lie, kids. A new industry report indicated that once 2022 rolls around, 20 million gamers will have switched from PC to console. That's the wrong way, why are they doing that? Although most of the attrition is expected to be with gamers who are using relatively cheap PCs, all market segments should be somewhat affected due to continued innovations and improvements in the console space. Of course, 20 million actually isn't a huge number when you consider how many there are in PC gaming, like 1.3 billion. But then again, how many of those do you think are just dads playing solitaire?
Probably a lot.
Yeah, they're probably just leaving because they don't play the good games, like the original Halo. And if Sony officially releasing information about the PlayStation 5 got you all rearing and ready to go to buy a new console, you might want to temper that excitement a bit, because you can't have it until 2020. So the earliest you might see one is next spring, but it's more probable that Sony will launch it around the holidays in 2020 to maximize hype. So you'll want to wear your battle armor to the mall around Christmas time to get it, I guess?
Yeah.
Yeah, or just be a tech YouTuber and have them send it to you. That's what I'll do. Actually, I don't even play consoles. I don't even want to say that. I'm not getting one. But yeah, I guess that's it. Goodbye.